a catalyst for human consciousness. And he has a whole theory of this. And that when we came out of the trees, we went to the dung of the ungulates and turned them over as monkeys, and they still do this today in the savannas, and they pick out the mushrooms to eat. Well, since psilocybe species is coprophilic and lives on dung, they would pick out psilocybe. It turns out, in low doses, psilocybe increases visual acuity. So in higher gender society, you get better eyesight, you hide better, you're selected for advancement. So people who ate the mushrooms advance over time. It turns out you eat more of those mushrooms, you get kind of horny. And if you get kind of horny, you have more kids. So here you are, a better hunter, having more kids. And then if you take massive doses, which of course would happen sometimes, then you see God. This is why we call him theogen. So he says human consciousness developed that way. Well, whether that's true or not, I think mushrooms have had a huge important part to play in every culture that we've dealt with.
Is herbal medicine, going way back to, you know, hunting, gathering, leading the caves, being a little In every tradition of the world, it doesn't matter what part of the world you come from, it has a rich tradition. If you follow it back enough,
cultures, all peoples, all races, ethnicities, religion, states.
It's actually the only tradition of healing that has been unbroken throughout most of history. Most parts of the world that you travel today, you still find people practicing some remnant of traditional herbalism. So I think it's such an honor to be part of that tradition today.
Okay, I guess.